NFS is, it's a means of file sharing in Linux and Unix environments. Now, if you were going to do this in a Windows environment, you want to use Samba and SIFS. That's another story, but in a Unix and Linux environment, it's a good tool, and it's commonly used. It uses the Network File System Protocol, hence the name NFS, which was developed by Sun Microsystems in the Orwellian year of 1984. It's built on the Open Network Computing Remote Procedure Call, or ONCRPC system. And by default, in Ubuntu 10.10 Maverick Meerkat, it's not installed. So you'll want to set this up and actually install it. I'm going to go and I'm just going to use sudo apt-get here. So sudo apt-get, and I want to install. And I'm going to do NFS, and I'm going to do kernel and server. And if you're prompted, just say yes. We need to install the daemons and the services before we can start modifying configuration files and exporting things. Okay. Now I need to make some directories to export, and to simplify that, I'm just gonna, I'm in the root directory, and I'm just gonna, put them out here so the paths are easy to kind of see or to ascertain. So mkdir, and I'm gonna do data 1. And 2 and 3, okay, in all caps. And by my umask 0022, the default permissions, if you were to list those, if I were to go up here, you'd see that they're all 755. I'm going to leave 2 and 3 as read only, but I want to make one writable. And I could probably do 775, but I'm just going to do 777. Obviously, don't want to put anything secure there, but sudo chmod 777 and data 1. Okay, so and again, you want to set up the POSIX permissions or local permissions. And again, just like with Samba, remember Samba, the permissions you set up share wise in the Samba conf file, as well as the permissions you have locally on the system in POSIX. It's the same way with NFS. What you export, you have permissions there. You can do read-only or read-write, and also it's the combination of your POSIX permissions. It's when you combine these permissions, remember, it's the most restrictive combination of the two, and actually it works the same in Windows. If you look at access control entries and a discretionary access control list, the local permissions in Windows combine with the network share permissions, and the most restrictive combination of the two applies. So, locally, if I have full privileges, but share-wise, I have read-only, then I have read-only across the network. Let's go and we're going to look at our... We're going to look at our file now, our exports file. So I want a cat, etc, and exports, which is the configuration file for NFS. And like everything else, it's an etc. And I'm going to edit it. So sudo nano, I'll need root privileges so I can save, and etc and exports. And then what I want to do down here, I start out with a blank file, but I want to add my directory structure. So in this case, data 1. And then the network I'm on is 199.207.13 and 0. Use the network portion of the address, by the way. And I'm going to add the subnet mask, so it's just a class C subnet mask. And in addition to that, I need to specify what kind of sharing I want to set up when I export the file system. So it'll be read-write, and it'll be synced, so synchronous. I'm going to do the second one now, data 2. And again, 199.207.13.0.255.255.255.0 subnet mask. And this time I'm going to do... just to show you the difference, even though I'm sharing this as read-write, because the local permissions were read-only, read and execute, you'll see that the combination of the two, you'll still only have read-only privileges on that directory. Even though the exports file says read-write, if the POSIX permissions say read-only, you just have read-only. But here on data 3 here, just to show you, another option, I'm going to do 207.13.0, same subnet mask, 255.255.0, oops, left off my 0 there, that would have been a problem. And, I could also specify read-only, if I wanted to in that file. Okay, so I have these three entries in my exports file here. And now what this will let me do is, once I restart the daemons and save my config file, I'll be able to mount these from another Unix or Linux client. So I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna go ahead and save this. I'm gonna do Control X, Y, and hit Enter to save it. I'm gonna verify it. Again, just verify that there are my directories. The paths are right. Make sure your POSIX permissions and your NFS share permissions are set up properly. And then the next thing that you'll want to do is export the file system. So I'm going to run a command here, sudo and export fs, and I'm going to use the dash a option just to kind of update the exported file system. Okay, looks like, yeah, things are a little bit different since I set this up in Red Hat and Fedora last time, but. All right, and then I just want to, basically restart the daemons or the services. Let me see. I have the Red Hat path. Okay, here's the Ubuntu path, I believe. So I'm going to do sudo and etc and init d and nfs kernel server and restart. Well, I have to put it in a different place.